range, but on steroids because you've got a whole lot of surface area and electrical properties that are enhanced with the charge.
You boost the CEC or cation exchange capacity of the soil by applying it.
What I find endlessly fascinating about biochar as well is that arguably the pollution of water on a planetary level can by and large be Brita-filtered in innumerable ways, like floating islands on...
Like giant disseminated Brita filter throughout our soils. Yeah.
Like you can plant on charcoal in water, and it, all the bioremediation can happen, and the desorption and glomming and the wonderful biochemistry that happens in bioremediation, a lot of that can be mediated by this, which is a decentralized, like, DIY potential. It doesn't have to be extraordinarily complex.
Another part of the hope that the tree forest ecosystem gives us.
Yes!
And
that's very cool. Are you literally talking during hydroponics on...
Coal.
But coal and water. Literally doing hydroponic...
I call it Chinampas, which was the Aztec floating gardens in Mexico City.
But the floating stuff was charcoal?
It wasn't necessarily, but it was
you're saying you
carbon.
Could.
It was carbon soil, based soil. And it was constantly cycling, but by using carbon,
you're going to achieve the results by supplementing wherever you're having water pass through soils, which is all of our agricultural soils in the world.
We
get that warm, but it's part of the process. That's called the co-benefit.
Is the combustion necessary for the carbon to be bound? Could it be superheated without combustion? I don't know if you heard the gas in a gym.
So you do want to limit the amount of oxygen that's that the material is exposed to, because carbon at temperature will burn and will oxidize, and all the biochar would disappear as CO2. So there's the retort I spoke of, is that's the vessel you're filling with biomass. That's to exclude oxygen from getting into the char that your biomass you're heating up, and by excluding it, it'll just release all the volatiles, all the smoke that's coming off right now, and then all the solid that remains won't be oxidized any further.
What percentage of the carbon that's in a log gets away in burning it? How much is left
about
over?
About 60. But let me interrupt because I'm going to go. What I do is drag and feed piles. Because I'm decentralized, I'm trying to do broad-scale systems. And by turning in the pile over and over again, you bury a lot of the coals under an ash. Then I shovel the coals into 55-gallon drums that I can bring in wheelbarrows and slap the lid on. And that's oxygen cleansing. Because I'm on a desert, I don't have water. So... you're going to do water. And so because I was asked, what do you do?
Yeah.
I do oxygen quenching instead of water quenching. And I end up with just the right range of pore size, of chunk sizes, for the heavy magnesium clays that we have, to cover the widest range of biomass. There's my short version. And now I have a long ride. So I'll be dead late tonight.
There's a white truck in our way.
Oh, let me.
A little white pickup.
don't